just previously in chapter 9 of our scripture reading today, we read of Saul's, and now named Paul's, conversion to Christianity, which we spoke of last week. Then the Apostle Peter heals a man thought to be paralyzed for life in the town of Lydda. And so this morning's reading comes from Acts chapter 9, verses 36 through 43. Let us listen for God's word. Now in the town of Joppa there was a disciple whose name was Tabitha, which in Greek is Dorcas. She was devoted to good works and acts of charity. At that time she became ill and died. When they had washed her, they laid her in a room upstairs. Since the town of Lydda was near Joppa, the disciples who heard that Peter was there sent two men to him. "Please come to us without delay." So Peter got up and went with them. When he arrived, they took him to the room upstairs. All the widows stood beside him, weeping and showing tunics and other clothing that Dorcas had made while she was with them. Peter put all of them outside, and then he knelt down and prayed. He turned to the body and said, "Tabitha, saints and widows, he showed her to be alive. This became known throughout Joppa, and many believed in the Lord. Meanwhile, he stayed in Joppa for some time, and certain Simon was with him. Sisters and brothers, this is the word of our Lord. Thanks be to God. We pick up with our sermon theme of encountering the risen Christ as we look at the story of Tabitha and Peter. I'd like for us to think about the relationship between authority and power in today's message. I think this topic is especially appropriate on this day, Mother's Day. Growing up, I always idealized the notion of having power in this world. Maybe most young people. We imagine having superpowers, maybe, accomplishing great feats of strength and making the world into what we want it to be. Superheroes, professional athletes, these were the guys, yes, guys, that I wanted to be growing up. I had it all planned out growing up in Cleveland. I was going to go into the ROTC program following high school, serve in the military, and become one of many of Ohio's greatest Republican politicians. What did happen? How about for you? These are symbols of power also that we deal with in this world. Time and time, the Christian church is a great example as it established its own power in what we call Christendom for the last 1,500 years. The church came up with wonderful theological explanations about these things, but why, really, is it that most churches are in the center of most towns? Or why do most churches have steeples that seem to reach above most other buildings? Why does the pastor wear a fancy speak from a position literally above everyone else? Not all of us get the power we dream about. In fact, this world is kind of messed up. Some may call it broken. And it seems like for the majority of people, the notion of power is something that will forever evade us in one form or another. Most of us won't grow up to be never got my chance to go into an ROTC program. I didn't have the math and science scores to qualify. our church here at Valley Community, instead of becoming more powerful over time, is discovering a new identity in a rapidly changing neighborhood. Well, we acknowledge that most of us live in a world and society where there are structures in place to keep those in power, and those without, without, based on education, religion, or economics, or race, or age, or orientation, or sex, and if you are a woman, then this notion of power really does seem more like a childhood fantasy than anything else. Power, it seems, is at play in just about every facet of our lives. But is it fair? Is it just? Is it what we really should be striving for? I'd like for us to be thinking about this as we hear a story that may not be all too familiar, but perhaps may be all too familiar to some in our lives today as we hear the story of a woman. Pick up in verse 36. Now in Joppa there was a disciple whose name was Tabitha. Tabitha was described as one of the disciples of Jesus. Did you know that there were female disciples? For some reason, that seemed to slip the mind of the authors of the Gospels for quite a while. We do know that she was beloved by those who knew her. She created beautiful clothing for others. Her quiet life and ways were acknowledged as many grieved for passing. So much so that other disciples called upon sad news. And then Peter showed up from a nearby town, and after performing a miracle just days before, he called for Tabitha to get up. Then she opened her eyes and seeing Peter, she sat up. He gave her his hand and helped her up. And calling the saints and widows, about the power of Peter? Was this a story of a lesser-known beloved Tabitha? Or was this about something even larger at work? Today we read a story of the Holy Spirit moving beyond the limits of life and death that we thought we once knew the rules to. Yes, we've heard of the story of Jesus being raised by God, but now even the apostles have such abilities. Today's story is not about power. It's about authority in Christ. And the good news for us this morning, we are all called to live our lives centered in God's authority in this world. And the authority we exhibit in this world will be Christ's. This authority is available to all who call upon Christ as Lord and Savior. We see wonderful examples of this today in both Peter and Tabitha as they point us ultimately to the authority found in Christ Jesus. When we follow such examples of living centered in Christ's authority, we open ourselves to faithful living that can be imagined beyond the very limited concepts of local power. The idea of the Trinity, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, becomes real and alive in ways that we never once knew. rest of my story growing up in school. I dreamed of having power in this world. And I ended up going to a small Presbyterian college in Louisville, Ohio instead. Then little by little, day by day, I learned about Jesus in a way that I never thought about. For Jesus, his life's message and ministry was not about power, but about authority. Time and time again, Jesus pointed to God as the source of such a life. Now, some of us think of Jesus as a very powerful figure. He was able to perform miracles, after all. He walked on water, he calmed storms, he rose from the dead. But the life of Jesus originated in the authority given to him by the Spirit of God and not the powers of this world. Peter understood this as well, as it was the Holy Spirit, the authority of God, that moved within him to be present for the miracles we read about in the book of Acts, so that others would experience the power of God in their lives. And Tabitha, the woman who we don't know too much about. Maybe Tabitha didn't go about town proclaiming Jesus to the crowds like Peter or Paul. But Tabitha lived her life led by the Holy Spirit, centered in God's authority. Tabitha helps represent so many women and men out there who do not have worldly power as we see it today, but live a radically faithful and powerful life by the standards of the kingdom of God. And God used the life of this beloved woman to illustrate victory over death when we base our very lives around the authority of our Lord and Savior. And for us here today, Valley Community, I'm here to tell you that we do not receive authority in God's kingdom by the world's symbols of power. There is nothing different between members and pastors when it comes to glorifying God in our lives. Our authority originates from the same place that Peter and Paul and even Tabitha found. We are called to live with the authority of God found in the risen Christ. Our faith is not based on worldly power. It is not based on this beautiful building or the good old days of being the large church in town. It's certainly not an outdated black robe that pastors have to wear. It is centered in Christ Jesus. The Christian church is no longer the center of such worldly power as it once was, but it wasn't the center of worldly power during the time that the book of Acts was being written either. What an exciting time it was then, and it is now. God calls us to center our lives in God's authority in this world. And when we do, God will use our lives, no matter if we are superheroes or athletes or loving women and men simply seeking to follow Jesus. And God will demonstrate a holy power in ways that the world has never seen. God wants to